Hey guys, I'm Tyler and welcome back to Day-to-Day DIY in the new DIYTyler shop, which means that we've moved. A lot of you guys probably know that. And as we moved, my tools were out on their own in the wild countryside. Not really, they were in the barn of the new house, but that means there was no climate control. This is what tools are supposed to look like. This is the cast iron top of the table saw. Nice and slippery, no rust, shiny, looks awesome. This, on the other hand, is the bandsaw. This makes me sad, and it doesn't make the tools work very well. Today, I'm going to show you guys the DIYTyler method of preventing this kind of rust from happening on the tabletops of your tools. If you should run into a situation like this, best way I found to get it off is with a scouring pad and an orbital sander without any sanding pad on it. If you got a really big problem, you can actually sand it as long as you do it pretty evenly with a super high grit to get the deep pores of the rust out of your cast iron tabletop. For cleaning up rust like this, I like to use these abrasive pads from Gator Grit. They're not sponsoring these videos. They did happen to send me these, but I always liked them. You can get Gator Grit at your local home centers if you guys are interested. And these are abrasive enough, but not too much for your cast iron tops. And then take a orbital sander without any sanding pad on it. Simply throw your abrasive pad on there, put your sander on top, and go to town cleaning off all of this rust. Do make sure you have the debris off it before, just because it will gum up the abrasive pad. So there we are, nice and clean and shiny again. Looking good. I did have to go to a heavier pad in a couple areas over here and then just finish it off with the fine again to give it that nice shiny look. I've used a couple different materials to apply to the table to help keep the moisture off and give it a nice sliding surface for your work pieces to slide over. I've used wax, that works well, but it gets a little bit sticky after time. And it can also build up on your work pieces, which can be a bit of an issue. You have to apply it quite a bit. I've been using this dry lube with Teflon in it for quite a while now, and it actually seems to work pretty well. I am anxious to see that now it's a different shop. The climate control is not a house, but it's pretty good with the mini split, if this keeps the rust off as well. But this is what I have been using for the past probably 2 years. This one happens to be by Blaster, again, not a sponsor, and you can get this at the local home centers. Works pretty well, leaves a super slippery surface, which is awesome to work with. None of your effort of pushing the wood through the work pieces is for sliding it over the table. It's all through the blade, and you can feel everything that's going on there, so it's probably a little bit safer. To apply it, it's simply a matter of spraying on an even coat. If you watch closely here, you can see how quickly it's drying into a nice clear coat of Teflon on there. Once it's dry, I do wipe off most of the excess with a paper towel. You can see right here, that's basically what you're going for. And I'll show you that once it's all dry here in a second. I do want to put out a little bit of a warning. I've heard that Teflon can damage some plastics. I don't know which, so just use at your own risk, I guess. It seems to work great on the tabletops though. So this is dry now. Go ahead and wipe it off. Wipe off most of it. You will see a little bit of the different spots on there, but it doesn't come off on your finger once you wipe it off here. At least on the can that I just used, it does say you can spray it on your blades, which I suppose would help with any pinching that you might have, allowing just a cleaner cut. If you look carefully right there, you can see the kind of spots that I was talking about. Still perfectly smooth and no residue right there. That's awesome. Well, there you go, guys. I hope you enjoyed that video. My best advice is never let your tabletops get to that point. That's the best way to keep them in excellent shape. But what I just showed you can get them back to pretty excellent shape without too much trouble. If any of you guys are looking for this stuff, I'll try to find a link and leave it in the description down below. If you like what you see, please hammer that thumbs up button. Hit the subscribe button right over there so you never miss when I upload a new video. I'm DIYTyler, and you guys have a good one.
That's my favorite part of everything.
You like that one?
Yeah, jump up.